messages from that date. They included all the messages we now have except the "We'll stop it" text message. Why didn't the Justice Department produce that to Congress when we asked?
Mr. DeSantis, I spoke with our Inspector General, Michael Horwitz, yesterday, and he told me that when he testified, he didn't have a full opportunity to explain, and the technological details are pretty complicated, but he assured me he had had a long telephone conversation with Mr. Jordan after the hearing and explained it. He's much better positioned than I. What I can assure you...
So let me just ask this then.
If I could just explain, sir, I want to assure you and the American people, we're not withholding anything embarrassing. The message was not in the original material that Inspector General, he found these messages?
Right, so you guys didn't find it, and he did. And so we're asking you to produce stuff, and obviously, you know, we're expecting a good faith effort. You guys didn't find it, and maybe somebody else deleted it or something happened before you guys, but he was able to find it and you didn't. So it was very disappointing to see that text message there, because I think you would agree. Just think of the timeline here. You have Peter Strzok. He opens up the counterintelligence investigation against Trump's campaign the end of July. Then a week later, this text message, he ain't going to be president, we'll stop it. Then the next week, the infamous insurance policy text message where he says, we can't take the risk of a Trump presidency, you need an insurance policy. The American people see that. Doesn't that undermine the whole integrity of the actions of people like Peter Strzok?
Yes, Congressman, that obviously is highly inappropriate. And,
well, it's more than that, though.
It's
more than that. I mean, the Inspector General did find that the bias affected. He didn't say it affected the decision about Hillary, but he said once we got into the fall, when you had the Huma Abedin emails, and there was slow walking on that by Peter Strzok, he was really concerned with pursuing this collusion investigation. And he testified on the record that it was absolutely reasonable to say that the bias not only existed, but affected what he did. Let me ask you this. What did the DOJ or FBI do in terms of collecting information, spying, or surveillance on the Trump campaign, be it via Stefan Halper or anybody else working on behalf of the agencies?
As you know, Congressman, I'm not permitted to discuss any classified information in an open setting, but I can assure you that we are working with oversight committees and we're producing all relevant evidence that will allow them to answer those questions.
Let me ask you this then. Did the Obama administration, anybody in the administration, direct anybody, Halper or anybody else, to make contact with anyone associated with the Trump campaign?
As I said, Congressman, I appreciate, obviously, I understand your interest, but I'm not permitted to discuss classified information.
Well, we want the documents, so I know we're in a back and forth on that, but the American people need to know, were the counterintelligence powers of the Obama administration unleashed against Trump's campaign? If that was done, was it done inappropriate? Let me ask you this. You know, they talk about the Mueller investigation. It's really the Rosenstein investigation. You appointed Mueller. You're supervising Mueller. And it's supposedly about collusion between Trump's campaign and Russia and obstruction of justice. But you wrote the memo saying that Comey should be fired. And you signed the FISA extension for Carter Page. So my question is to you, seems like you should be recused from this more so than Jeff Sessions, just because you were involved in making decisions affecting both prongs of this investigation. Why haven't you done that?
Congressman, I can assure you that if it were appropriate for me to recuse, I'd be more than happy to do so and let somebody else handle this, but it's my responsibility to do it. And all I can tell you, sir...
Then how do you have obstruction of justice possibility for a president exercising his powers to fire an FBI director that you said should be fired? And, oh, by the way, the IG report makes it clear Jim Comey should have been fired. So why are we still doing this with the Mueller probe?
Sir, I am not commenting on what is under investigation by the Mueller probe. And to the best of my knowledge, neither is Mr. Mueller. I know there's a lot of speculation in the media about that. But that doesn't relieve me of my obligation not to discuss the subject matter of the investigation.
Do you accept what IG Horowitz said regarding Peter Strzok and the fall campaign with Huma Abedin emails, how he slow-walked that versus how he was so gung-ho about the Trump-Russia collusion? Remember, he texted Lisa Page. The other thing, Hillary mattered because we didn't want to mess it up, but this matters because it matters. That's what he wanted to do, and that's where he was focusing his energy on. Horowitz said his bias is an appropriate explanation for his conduct. Do you agree?
I certainly agree with the findings of the Inspector General report, and I think those messages clearly do indicate bias.
Well, you guys have some work to do, because if the bias is affecting official action, that is a big, big problem. I yield back the balance of my time.